The one that the Holy Prophet says must remain with it. The other one must be with it all the time. Our Sunni brothers always say it is Quran and Sunnah that the Holy Prophet left behind. And the Shias have claimed that it is Quran and Ahlul Bayt. Quran and the Holy Prophet's Itrat. Itrati Ahl Bayti. The book that I have in front of me is named Mawsul al-Hadith al-Sharif al-Kutub al-Sitta. Or the Sahih al-Sitta, the six major books of our Sunni brothers. Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, Jami Tirmidhi, Sunan Abu Dawud, Sunan Nisa'i, Sunan Ibn Majah. It was printed in Darul Nashr, Darul Salam wa Nashr wa Tawzil al-Riyadh. It is printed in Saudi Arabia, Riyadh. If you wanted any references, I'll be giving it from this. Now, the first reference that I wanted to give is from Hadith al-Thaqalain, known to be Hadith al-Thaqalain, the Hadith of the two weighty things. The Holy Prophet leaves behind two things. My first point that I want to make in this session tonight is that the Holy Prophet left behind two things, and the claim that those two things are Quran and Sunnah must be proved from these six major books by our Sunni brothers. We say that the Holy Prophet left behind two weighty things, Quran and Ahlul Bayt. And I'll be giving you references from Sahih Muslim. And the words have appeared in Sahih Muslim in this volume, 1102. Page number 1100. Obviously, this is one volume containing all six Sahih Sittah. So obviously, the chapters will be different. Babul Imara. Hadith number 2408 in Sahih Muslim. The Holy Prophet says, in the plains of Ghadir, he says in the way back from Ghadir or in the way back from Hajj, the Holy Prophet stopped in a place Baina Makkah wal Madina, between Makkah and Medina. In this place he says, Qama Rasulullah yawman fina khatiban bima'in yudha khumman. Ghadir khum. Ghadir meaning ma, a place where there is water gathered together. And khum is the place of that ghadir, of that pond or an area that had water. We always call it Ghadir or Ghadir Khum. Khum is the name of the place. Between Makkah and Medina, Fahamidallahu wa Rahman alayh, the Holy Prophet praised the Almighty and did extol Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Waba'ata wa dhakkara. And he extolled his people, he did admonishment to the people. And then he said, Amma ba'ad, ala ayyuhun nas, O people, فَإِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشِرٌ يُشَكُوا أَنْ يُؤْتِيَ رَسُولُ رَبِّي فَأُجِيبُوا. Soon the message of Allah, messenger of Allah, an angel will be coming to me and I will say, لَبَّيْكْ to him, I will go back, meaning I will be dying very soon. وَأَنَا تَارِكٌ فِيكُمْ فَقَلَيْنِ. The words of Sahih Muslim. I'm leaving behind two things. أَوَّلُمَا كِتَابُ اللَّهِ فِيهِ الْهُدَى وَالنُّورِ فَخُذُوا بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. The first one of them is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is guidance and light. Take the book of Allah. فَاسْتَمْسِكُوا بِهِ. Do not leave it. فَحَفَّ عَلَىٰ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَرَغَبَ فِيهِ. The Holy Prophet emphasized the importance of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ قَالَ. Then he said, وَأَهْلُ بَيْتِي أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي وَأُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهَ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِي. The Holy Prophet said, and the second is, my Ahlul Bayt. Then three times repeated, I remind you the importance of my Ahlul Bayt. I remind you the importance of my Ahlul Bayt. I remind you the importance of Ahlul Bayt. My progeny, my Ahlul Bayt. فَقَالَ لَهُ حُسَيْن. وَمَنْ أَهْلُ بَيْتِهِ. Zayd was asked by a person called Hussein with a sword, not with a scene. Who are his Ahlul Bayt? Ya Zayd, أَلَيْسَ نِسَاهُ مِنْ أَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ. Are his wives not his Ahlul Bayt? قَالَ نِسَاهُ مِنْ أَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ. His wives are his Ahlul Bayt. وَلَكِنْ أَهْلُ بَيْتِهِ مَنْ حُرِمَ الصَّدَقَةُ بَعْدَهُ. His Ahlul Bayt are the ones upon whom sadaqa is haram. قَالَ وَمَنْ. Who are the ones upon whom sadaqa is haram? قَالَ آلُ عَلِيٍّ. They are the children of Ali ibn Abi Talib. وَآلُ عَقِيلٍ. They are the children of Aqil. وَآلُ جَعْفَرٍ. Children of Ja'far. Basically, the children of Abu Talib. وَآلُ عَبَاثٍ. قَالَ كُلُّ هَمَلَا يَحْرَمَ صَدَقَى. قَالَ نَعَمْ. All of these upon whom sadaqa is haram? He said yes. So the first point that I wanted to make, inshallah, we should all remember, the Holy Prophet left behind two, the Book of Allah and his Ahlul Bayt. Many people think that when discussing the Shia Sunni thing, it takes away people from each other. I always think it brings people together. Because if there are any confusions, they will be removed. And the enemies of Islam has always tried to divide the Muslims. If you discuss, there will be so many common things between the two major sects, the Shias and the Sunnis. When you discuss those things, you will become closer to each other rather than becoming further away from each other. So the first point that I wanted to make is about the hadith of Allah, the Holy Prophet, that the Holy Prophet left behind two things, the Book of Allah and his itrat, his holy progeny. If there are any questions on this, I would answer, otherwise I will continue. If there are any questions or any comments or anything that anyone wanted to say. The hadith itself?
No, the question you just asked.
If there are any questions or any comments that you wanted to ask or say, yes, anything about this hadith so far or about anything that I've said so far. Otherwise, I'll continue. Yes, brother at the back.
Assalamu alaikum, brother. My question was regarding the hadith. You quoted the hadith, obviously, which is a mashallah, excellent thing. Can you give reference in the Quran where the sadaqah is haram for the human being?
An ayah from the Holy Quran that the sadaqah is haram upon Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay. Now, the status of Ahlul Bayt has been mentioned throughout the Holy Quran. And the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ahzab, Surah number 33, has mentioned the status of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. And he says that they are not like any other people. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ وَرِجْسَ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. That the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept away all rijs, danas, all the different types of najasat or filth away from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. This verse that appeared in the Surah 33, verse number 33, Surah Ahzab, they are Ahlul Bayt. The words are إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ. Allah keeps away from you. لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ رِجْسَ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتِ. Allah keeps away the rijs from Ahlul Bayt. He does not say he keeps away Ahlul Bayt from rijs. Had he said that he keeps away the rijs from Ahlul Bayt, that would have meant that they would have always wanted to go towards rijs, but Allah kept them away. But no, Allah said Allah keeps away rijs from Ahlul Bayt. Meaning rijs would have wanted to come to Ahlul Bayt, but Allah kept the rijs away from Ahlul Bayt. Now look at all the things that have been regarded as rijs in the Holy Quran. فَاجْتَنِبُوا رِجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. Keep away from the idol worshipping because it is rijs, and keep away from lying because it is rijs. So two things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these are rijs. One is shirk, idol worshipping, and second is lying. إِنَّمَا الْخَبْرُ وَالْمَيْسَرُ وَالْأَسْلَامُ وَالْرِجْسُ مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ. These are rijs and amal shaitan. Drinking, gambling, aslam and saab. These four things have been counted as rijs, amal shaitan. Likewise, there are many other things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are 10 things that Allah has counted as rijs in the Holy Quran. The Holy Prophet says, صَدَقَةٌ is أَوْسَاخُ النَّاسِ. It is the filth of the hands of people. And upon my Ahlul Bayt, sadaqah is haram. These verses show that Ahlul Bayt are not ordinary people. They are not common people. They are not like all other people. They have been chosen. No rijs can go to them. Their status is higher than all the other people. When their status is higher than other people, then things which are permissible for common people, they are not permissible for Ahlul Bayt. Their status in terms of action, in terms of ismat, in terms of infallibility, in terms of what they do and what they can do and what they cannot do, is different to all other people. The Holy Prophet has many places said, when people brought sadaqah, he asked, he said, what is this? He said, Ya Rasulullah, this is sadaqah. He said, I do not eat it and do not give it to my Ahlul Bayt. Hassan and Hussein will not eat it. Give it to my Sahaba, my companions. So whenever those verses were revealed, the Holy Prophet explained and then he said, sadaqah is haram on the Ahlul Bayt. Any other questions?
Does that mean sadaqah is still
filled on the hands of the people that the Holy Prophet